What's going on, everybody? Kenny Dubs here with another Mega Man X Dive Challenge Mode Jacob Climb. This time we're going to be taking on floors 11 through 15, so let's get started. Alright, so the first floor has Buster up, so I'm going with Classic Mega Man and Military Buster, and I think the Mega Buster is what I went with. Same chips as I usually go with Ultimate Charge Shot on the Charge Shot, and on Leaf Shield, just the Charge Enhancement. For cards, I went with the Victroid, I think is the name of it, which has Buster Amplification, so that increases damage when I have a Buster equipped, and I just have the Alien card as well, because it's a yellow card. I switched my Victory card just because this one is maxed. I should have more than one max because I have so many of them, but I just switched to the max one just because I didn't. Actually, I might have had a second max one. I might have switched it off thinking that it wasn't max, but it was. Anyway, onto the floor. There isn't too much special going on during this floor, to be honest. A lot of it's just like shooting down the flying weenies, and then when the enemies drop, I take care of those. Now, the ride armors, I don't think I showed it in this. Let me see if I did. But what you can actually do against ride armors is kind of crouch. I'm too far away for it to hit me, but if you just crouch while they're punching, they legitimately can't hit you if your character is small enough. So characters like Sigmar or Massimo won't be able to duck because they're physically too big to duck. However, it's like ducking under Vile's shots, which is very, very nice because that means that later floors where a lot of ride armors spawn, depending on your character, you don't have to really worry too much about dodging them because you can just crouch under their shots, which is good. Like I said, not too much going on this floor. It's just a lot of it. It's just staying out of the enemy's way and firing at them from a distance. Now, Classic Mega does have Buster Master, which is why I went for him with this. You could have also gone with X if you opt to do that, or like I guess one of the other various X forms if you're doing, you know, choosing any characters. But yeah, not too much going on here, so I'll just let this play out, I guess, because there's not anything else to really commentate on. Alright, the next floor has a machine gun amplification on it, so I believe I switched to Axel here. Once I begin to get into this and swap my character, yes, I switched to Axel. And I'm just going to put on the Gatling gun, because Gatling gun is basically all I need for this. My Gatling gun is 4-star, which might be a bit higher level or higher rank than a lot of other people's Gatling guns. But as long as you have the Gatling gun, you should be fine, because I beat it with this at much lower than 4 stars. And I also go with the laser rifle here, which doesn't actually matter all that much, because I'm not really going to be using it. But, I mean, it's there, I guess. And for Axel, I just kind of go with like my standard loadout set. Again, maybe I should have switched the roll chip, but I go with the wide area shot just to increase the area which can be affected by the strafing barrage and the shield on the roll, because shields are really good. Both have excellent cards at 5-star because they're so easy to max, and there's really not much reason to not have them maxed. And my Axel is only at 2-star, so I don't really he's a 3-star, so I don't have as much flexibility with his chips and his cards just yet. Anyway, moving on to the floor, because I can just use a Gatling gun and not really have to worry about too much during this floor, there's really all that much to say. There are enemies on these platforms, but these platforms can be shot through by just about any kind of projectile, so you have to be careful of that. Outside of like the tips of the floors, I believe, you can't shoot through like the blue portions, but the Gatling gun is more than enough for this. You don't have to worry about too much else, to be quite honest. Weapon-wise, anyway, because you get the Gatling for free. And as you can see, the strafing barrage increased area is going to help out quite a bit, just because I can hit enemies off of two different platforms when I stand in a proper area, which is very, very nice. I do take quite a lot of hits here, though, which is unfortunate, because that just puts me in a bit of danger. And that's pretty bad. But you can roll through enemies as well because of the iframes you get during it. And I believe like right here, I tried to go Frustration Barrage, but unfortunately I missed because I'm just out of range of everyone I wanted to hit. I wanted to get everyone right there, but I was not able to, so that kind of sucked. Took a lot of damage there, and what that's going to allow is nothing, because it was over, never mind. I thought there were still a few more enemies, but the Gatling Gun is a very, very solid weapon, especially early on that we get free, so I didn't have to worry too much about that floor. Alright, the next floor has launcher amplification, so we're going to be using a launcher because of that. I'll be switching my character off of Axel for palette, just because I haven't gotten to my palette quota for the day. Same stuff as usual, additional tracking system on her arrows and on her ion gun. We're just going to be using the... I think I'm going to use actually the damage up on it? I don't remember. Yes, the damage up rather than the paralyzing current, which I might try the paralyzing current out at some point because it keeps them stunned longer. It does less damage, but I don't really care about it doing less damage, to be quite honest. And I don't even think I put cards in my palette this run. Okay, I guess I didn't because I didn't show it. Or if I did, you'll see bat healing. But I don't think that I ended up putting bat on palette this time. So this run is just mostly the wheels, which is kind of annoying. Okay, no, I did put bat on palette. My bad. So bat and a green card put up on a pallet. So yeah, I've seen Chameleon, and I believe I have Mao on my chips loadout. So this floor is kind of annoying just because of the wheels, and it's kind of difficult to hit them with the launchers. However, you can just use whatever weapon you want because the damage modification isn't that large. But it just means if you use this weapon, you know, it'll go a little bit faster. And dodging the wheels actually isn't all that bad until there's multiple of them coming at you at once. You see right there, like, I kind of easily dodged them, but as they're coming back, like, they end up hitting me because there's so many of them on the screen at once. And using Palace Ion Gun, if I can line it up right, I can get damage on quite a few of them, which is what I try to do, along with using some of her arrow skill, but... I mainly try to use the Ion Gun because it has such a wide radius... or watch such a wild field of attack that I can just pretty easily take out the wheel enemies. I don't know their name, like Wheel Joe or something. I'm not actually sure. No, I think I'm thinking of confusing with Sniper Joe. And as usual, I jump in the air with Pallet when I use her Ion Gun because that allows I don't have to deal with the recoil of her Ion Gun. And yeah, all you have to really do is time your dashes. I guess you could jump over them too, but I find it easier just to kind of dash under them. As you can see, that's what I'm trying to focus on doing because it's a lot easier for me to do that anyway. And one more Ion Gun, and I clean up that wave, and this should be the last wave right here. I don't think I'm gonna get another Ion Gun off, but yeah, that's it for this wave. No, I lied. There is one more wave. I thought that was it because I started standing in the middle, but I think that's just... because I went to stand in the middle. The elevator didn't even stop, so I should have known that wasn't it. But that's it for this floor. Next up, floor 14. It's one of those annoying floors where you have to use a sword. So I'm bringing 0Z for multiple reasons. My 0Z is at 4 stars, so I have access to the zero knuckle skill, which allows me to heal sometimes off of getting a zero knuckle resolved, and put bat on him as well, simply because it's just more healing. But on top of that, the floor description said there's a lot of destruction of certain mobs, so you know what that means. That means the orb enemies, which are a pain for people to deal with. Anyway, 0Z, just the basic stuff. I have the arm destruction on the zero knuckle, which doesn't actually come into play, and I have the range increase on the shield boomerang, because that might actually come into play. So, once we're on the floor, I kind of have to play a bit safe. Like, you're going to see the way I go about doing some of these is it's pretty interesting. So, right off the bat, I prioritize the orbs, because that gets I forgot the name of the chip. The Mega Scorpio chip. Happening in the middle, which will allow me to have the shockwave. As the shockwave, since it's coming off of a blade weapon, it counts for the destruction of that mob, which is good. So you're going to use that to just kind of have a DOT over areas of the map you're not in. And right there, I try to get fancy and try to just zero knuckle the airborne enemy, and I'm unfortunate with that timing. So just though I wanted to heal, but I'm using the Z saber and or Sander saber and the triangle saber. Because the triangle saber, it's a free weapon that everyone has access to, and you can farm it pretty easily. Now these orbs, the order I'm taking them out in is so that they kind of don't overwhelm me and like in the middle of my safe spots. I try to go for the orbs in the middle first, but right there you see I get caught again, which sucks. Though I do get the bat heal, which isn't very much to be honest, but you know, it's something. Here I get caught again, which is pain. But there isn't much I can do, because I have to jump in order to hit these. Like, I can't not do that. But this is the last wave of them, I believe. So, despite my HP looking low and looking like I'm in danger, I'm really not in all that much danger. And I go for I use the Standard Saber, because the Standard Saber has Defense Crush on it. So, at the very least, when I'm using the Standard Saber, when I switch off over to that, I'll be getting some healing. Now, I didn't actually use Shield Boomerang in this. Which I should have done to try and take out some of the airborne weenies, but I think my thought process was, if I get the zero knuckle on them, I can get potential healing, which might have helped, to be honest. I don't think I got much zero knuckle healing that run, but in any case, I finished up that run. It wasn't too bad. And now we're on the floor 15. Floor 15 is the reason why this video is coming out so late. First of all, it has amplification for sprayers, which is going to be important for beating this floor. And if you have access to Alia, you can Hermit Creepers, damage will speed up by 50%. However, the reason this floor took so long was because I've already beat this floor, the game just registers that I've already beaten this floor. And if I do this floor again, it treats it as if it's like, hey, you beat this floor. So when I went back in to do this floor again, I weakened the bosses to a point where I had one boss left with low HP. But because the game knows that I beat this floor, it just reset the floor entirely. So I have to do this all in one run, which sucks because I didn't realize that like the first two times I did that. First run, I got down to Overdrive Ostrich. Then I clicked the wrong stage by accident and thought that was the reason why. So then I waited another day to record this. As you can see, I'm level 84 instead of 80. And then the second time, I got to Overdrive Ostrich down to I beat both of them, but the time ran out after I beat them because the timer still ticks down, so that sucks. Anyway, on with this floor. I'm using Massimo because Massimo is great for Orbital Elevator, and I'm using both of his skills, Shield Chips, because that is also great for this. And I have the Bat Card on. Now, the reason I have the Bat Card on, because you might have already seen it, but the Ice Penguins that Shield Penguin summons counter as enemies, and you can actually get health back from them, right? As you see right there, I just got about 400 HP back from that, which is pretty nice. Now, I'm using the Snowy Sprayer, because Snowy Sprayer is pretty good, and it's free. Having it at 4-star would be great for this, but I don't have mine at 4-star at the time of recording this. And I'm using the Compressed Sprayer. Now, the Compressed Sprayer actually does a heck of a lot of damage. Like, the amount of damage it can output is a lot higher than the other sprayers. And after I switched to the Compressed Sprayer was when I was able to much more quickly beat this, as opposed to using the not the gas emitter, the fiery sprayer. Because when I used the fiery sprayer, I beat it with like 5 seconds left, and then I timed out because it waits till the boss's death animation is finished to do that. Now, normally I would go after Order of Ostrich first, but I found that actually going after Chill Penguin first is a bit easier, actually, because I think Chill Penguin's easier to deal with, but it's more annoying when there's a two of them, right? Because Chill Penguin is constantly, trying to CC you. Like, he'll inflict slow. He will, he'll do the icy wind thing, or the northern wind, I'm not sure what it's called. And that allows Overdrive Ostrich to kind of just run into you and cause contact damage. But Chill Penguin's down pretty simply, and now we just have Overdrive Ostrich left, which is going to go down pretty easily as well. I beat them with much more time left on the clock this time, about 17 seconds when the death animation starts, as opposed to 5 seconds. So I will be more than okay by the time the death animation finishes, because it looks like it takes 11 seconds for the death animation to finish, which is a pain. So that does mean for future floors, I might have to do do a more powered clear of them just so that I can do it all in one run as opposed to just using more free units. Because I've done quite a few floors before I decided I wanted to record this run. But I probably am going to have to use more powerful characters and weapons. But that's going to be it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to help the channel out. Shows me that you're enjoying the content. And I'll see you guys next time with more Jacob's Orbital Elevator. Next time we'll be going through floors 16 through 20. Later.